It's 9:02. It looks like this is the place. I'm not the only one here participating 9:05. Hey guys, what is going on location out here in Ankara, Turkey, and today is Mustafa Kemal Atatürk's Memorial Day. Today is November 10th, which is Mustafa Kemal Atatürk's Memorial Day. Right now I'm in Ankara at the intersection where Kızılay metro station is. You can see it's a very busy intersection, and I chose this on purpose because at 9:05 a.m. on November 10th, which is the minute that Mustafa Kemal Atatürk passed away, something happens across the country here in Turkey, and we are going to check it out. I was told about this in the comments. A lot of you guys messaged me on Instagram. I even got some messages this morning telling me, make sure you're out of bed, get out to a crowded area, experience this. So here I am. I am going to try and do this in the most respectful way. In the comments, you guys said that it's okay to film it, so I'm going to. And got about 5 more minutes. That is incredible. I got the chills. Wow. I was definitely in the right place for it. That was amazing. I knew what was going to happen. I knew traffic was going to stop and everybody was going to stop. But being right in the middle of it when it happened and you're just anticipating it. Yeah, that was an experience, man. Wow. You can definitely feel the admiration and respect that the people of Turkey have for their founding father. That's for sure. So right now, we are on our way to Anıtkabir, the mausoleum of Atatürk. I guess it's going to be very busy today. As expected, it's looking more and more like this place is going to be absolutely jam-packed. Let's check it out. So far, I've gone through security twice. Give me a pat down and check my bag. And it looks like I will do it one more time. And then we've got the crowds. Made it through three pat downs, metal detectors. We got turnstiles. I'm feeling quite safe. Feeling very safe over here. We are now outside of Anıtkabir, mausoleum of Mustafa Kemal Atatürk. As you can see, the Turkish flag is at half mast, which it'll be flying at half mast across the country today. This mausoleum was designed by two architects, Professor Emin Onat and Assistant Professor Ahmed Orhan Arda. It looks pretty busy up there. I don't know what kind of view we'll get, but we are going to take a look, of course. Let's see if I can get up there. I think I'm in the background of probably thousands of pictures. Everybody's taking pictures. We made it up the steps.
Zambia.
It took about 45 minutes so far, but I would guess that people would wait a lot longer than that to pay their respects to the father of the Turks. I'm not sure if it's appropriate to film inside. I'm going to see. If it's not, then I won't. And I will see you on the other side over there.
Yok, bayağı bağırıyor ya, ses çıkmıyor. Alkışlamayın lütfen. Alkışlamayın.
The burial place of Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, the most beloved man in Turkish history. Because of him, there is a Turkish flag. The location of this mausoleum is just a very beautiful view of the city. Better move. People probably don't want me in the background of their pictures. Yeah. It was about an hour, a little over an hour wait. Luckily it didn't rain, but I do think if it was raining it would not matter. Let's take one more look at the mausoleum before we move on to one more place. It's turning out to be a pretty nice day. I wore this sweatshirt, it was a bit cooler this morning. Wore a red one to support the Turks. All right, we continue. We've arrived at our final stop for today. This is Victory Monument, and it is depicting Mustafa Kemal Atatürk as an officer in World War I, where he famously rode into battle and was victorious in the Battle of Gallipoli. So around him you will see two male soldiers in the front and a woman in the back carrying a cannon to represent the everyday people's contributions to victory. And I think for those who don't know, it's important to talk about what Atatürk did to become so beloved that he has all of these banners around the country here. So he founded the country, the Republic of Turkey, and he did so at a time right after they had lost World War I, the European powers had come in and taken Istanbul. Greece had come across and taken Izmir, and things were not looking good. But in 1923, he was able to establish the Republic of Turkey. And not only that, he did things like change the alphabet from Arabic script to Romanized script. He aligned Turkey with the West. He introduced a lot of reforms for women's equal rights. He stopped the practice of polygamy. He also abolished the caliphate and the sultanate and separated church and state. So Mustafa Kemal Atatürk did a lot for the Turks and for the Republic of Turkey. And as you saw in this video today, they really appreciate it. So if there's anything that I forgot to say about Atatürk's accomplishments, you can write it in the comments. I'm sure there is a lot more information out there. I tried to cover as much as I could. So that is going to be it for this video. If you made it this far, please give it a like, please subscribe. I'm very happy that I got to be here for the 100 year anniversary, November 10th. And now I can start traveling around covering the cities around Turkey. So stay tuned, there's a lot more on the way.